Hello, and welcome to today's video where I'll be covering my webcomic process in Clip Studio Paint. In today's video, we'll be taking a look at Clip Studio Paint's filters menu and discussing some ways you can use filters to enhance your webcomics. Links to additional tutorials and everything mentioned in today's video will be down in the description below. If you want to give your comic some extra visual appeal and polish, one of the easiest ways is through filters. In Clip Studio Paint, you can access the library of filters by going to the Filter drop-down menu. The filters are broken up into six categories: Blur, Correction, Distort, Effect, Render, and Sharpen, with a total of over 20 filters to choose from. For the purposes of this video and the next, I'll be highlighting some of the more useful filters and separating them into two categories, Artistic and Practical. Artistic filters are ones that add a unique visual element to elevate your work. Practical filters are ones that work more like utility tools to help clean, smoothen, or tweak your work. Together, they can be incredibly helpful in achieving the perfect look for your webcomic. Today we'll be covering practical filters, and in the next video we'll tackle the artistic ones, so be sure to check back on the channel soon if you'd like to learn more. Of all the practical filters, here are a few of my favorites. Under the Correction menu, the Adjust Line Width filter is a tool for those looking to make adjustments to their line art after it's been drawn. I personally always draw my line art on a vector layer so I can manipulate it pretty easily. But what if you've drawn your lines traditionally and scanned them in, or you just prefer using a raster layer? If you wanted to thicken up your line art, you'd either have to draw it again or find some workaround. With this filter, however, you can simply adjust the slider, and Clip Studio Paint will automatically make those adjustments to the line art for you. Note that this only works on line art that's been drawn on a transparent layer. If your line art was drawn traditionally and scanned in, you'll have to isolate it by using the Convert Brightness to Opacity setting under the Edit menu if you want to adjust the line thickness with this filter. Here's a trick I've learned from doing comics. When drawing objects in a background, you can convey distance by the thickness of the item's line weight. The thicker the lines, the closer it appears to the reader, and vice versa. By making the lines of the object closest to the reader extra thick, you can easily give your scene some more depth. Try this technique out using the Adjust Line Width tool next time you're working on a background, and you may just end up with better results. For those of you doing traditional line art on paper, another awesome filter in the Correction menu is the Remove Dust filter, which picks out and removes any dots or marks left behind during scanning. As you can see, Clip Studio Paint will detect that there's little dots here and get rid of them for you. You can adjust its sensitivity through the options in the drop-down menu here. Finally, under the Effect menu, Remove JPEG Noise is a useful filter for smoothing out any imported materials that suffer from artifacting. This can also be helpful in preparing photographs to be more usable for artistic filters. As you can see, using this filter removes a lot of the fuzziness from the image. For an even smoother look, just apply the filter a few more times until you're happy with the result. This filter can be a lifesaver if you ever accidentally shrank something too small or saved it at a poor quality resolution. There are lots of ways Clip Studio Paint's filters can be used to heighten your work, so be sure to experiment and find what techniques work best for your project. Those are the basics for how I use filters when making webcomics in Clip Studio Paint. In the next video, I'll be covering artistic filters and some ways you can use them for your webcomics as well. Check the description below for my social media links and more tutorials. Thanks for watching, and I hope to see you next time.